can you go back and look as collectively as a group, just what stood out from last night that maybe didn't stand out as much last night?
Philip Bean right here.
Is it?
Yeah.
Oh, no.
Is there, is it?
No, no, I don't see it.
Show us again.
I'd be like the clear skin of a bean or something, but I don't see it.
Mm, might be it.
Yeah, yeah.
Yeah, clear skin of a bean. I'm sorry, what was your question?
I don't remember. No, it was just anything stand out when you look back that maybe didn't kind of pop off the page immediately last night?
You know, offensively, I thought, again, we've thrown a lot at them, and we have a lot of new faces, and they did a pretty good job executing for our first preseason game, especially with me playing the different combinations that we played. I thought our guys did a great job with paint touches. You know, I think we ended up with 50-something points in the paint, and you know, for us, which is, it was pretty high. You know, so that was big. But you know, the same thing defensively. We felt that our ball pressure and our physicality wasn't quite there, and especially from the beginning, they got really comfortable. And when an NBA team gets comfortable, the sky's the limit for them. And you know, like I said before, they were on pace to set an NBA record against us for made threes. So thank goodness it was a preseason. It'd be fun tomorrow to see if we can clean some of that up while not losing too much of what we're trying to do offensively.
Some of those things you focus on defensively, especially with the perimeter right there. Did you see evidence of that over these past few weeks, or did that kind of catch you all off guard?
That's the thing. We've been pretty physical in practice. Our ball pressure has been pretty good. And it was almost like we took a little step backwards when the lights were on in terms of our physicality, our ball pressure, and even our communication to a certain degree.
What's the plan for tomorrow? Are you same thing, starters first half and then backups in the second half?
No, so I'll play our starters into the third.
Okay.
And then I won't finish the game with them. Probably the game after that, they'll finish the game. And you know, they'll still have three preseason games, I think, to do that.
And don't read anything into the rotations that you'll throw out tomorrow or
no, Sunday? No. From the standpoint that I'm trying to take a look at anything and everything, you know, but nothing is like tomorrow. That wouldn't be my final rotation pattern or whatever.
When you saw the offense clicking the way it was, specifically in that early going,
yeah,
I imagine you've seen that come together over the past couple of weeks in camp as well, but giving them the freedom to kind of choose their own plays and move the ball the way they did, yeah. Was that about as good as it gets from this offense?
Yeah, obviously I wish we would have had an opportunity to shoot more threes. You got to give Golden State some credit, though, for that, because they were really conscious of trying to get us off the three-point line. I don't know if I've, at least since I've been here, where we've had more back doors for layups than last night, you know, and we have them built in our system. We just never understood how to set your guy up and how to cut the score and look for it. You know, we got a guy that's going to make the pass and dome us. And now we just have to keep doing what we're doing, which is when I do cut, every time I cut, it's to score. And now if I don't get it, I got to make sure I re-space. And, you know, if you got a guy that's 6'8" in Keegan or even in Jalen cutting back door and he's got a guy on him that's 6'3" or smaller, you're going to have a chance to get that ball over the top and finish at the rim before the weak side defense comes. And so we have to keep looking for it because our wings are pretty big and they have some decent athleticism and Domus knows where to place that basketball. So that was one thing that was pretty impressive by our group on the offensive end is how many times we did cut the score, and we finished the play with a layup because we cut the score or cut with a purpose.
You mentioned your own three-point shooting last year. I think you guys were around top five in attempts. Do you want to stay around that coming into this year?
Oh, for sure. You know, and it's a little bit of a fine line because if you guys – bless you – because if you have players like in DeMar – that are such elite mid-level scorers, And Keegan may be that. You know, he's still too early to determine. Box could be that. Malik can be that. You know, you always look at the shot profile and you think layups or threes. And when you have guys that can go get it in a medium game, you kind of want to let them have some freedom to a certain degree to be able to go do it. You know, I was part of a series that in the playoffs when I was with the Warriors and we played the Rockets back in the day, and their shot profile was, hey, you got to take a layup or you got to take a three. And we knew that. We knew they weren't going to shoot the in-between game, and so that's what we geared our defense for. And I think they ended up missing 20-something straight threes or something like that, and we ended up winning the game and the series, in my opinion, because they didn't. I think they might have had guys that could do it. I don't know, but they didn't do it. And so we only had to guard two areas of the floor. And so, again, if you have guys that can do it, you, to a certain degree, you want to give them some freedom as long as it's not too much. And the shot's going in. But I was happy overall with our offensive performance.
DeMar, 6-for-6, was that about as good of a debut, barring preseason, that you could have really expected out of him?
Yeah, again, he's a guy that if he gets to a spot, he's just so comfortable. And you can, you know, the game is easy. He wasn't out of sorts, or he wasn't in any type of rush or hurry or anything like that. And, you know, to be able to have a guy that can score the way he did, or as fluid or as easy as he did, definitely makes the game easier for everybody else. And, you know, there was one play where he was in position to go back door, and he set his guy up and he cut back door and he kind of looked for it. And whoever was guarding him, I mean, they were right on his hip, because they know he can come out that weak side and catch and shoot a little middie or catch and go. And while he was cutting back door, Fox was getting a handoff to his left hand and he's going downhill. And, you know, you watch Fox shoot that layup, you think like he's playing pickup against us. You know, he just goes down and lays it up because of the attention that DeMar created. Going at that time, he was maybe 3-for-3 or 4-for-4. And so when you have a guy like that, it just makes the game so much easier for everybody else that, you know, you're happy that he's on your team.
I don't know if you missed your presser last night, so apologies, but the confidence level maybe that you have with Isaac at the moment, and what you're seeing from him, talking to him, it seems like his skill set is something that isn't really duplicated on the roster, and I wonder how much that might set him apart.
Right. I mean, you guys saw it firsthand. And his story is interesting, like I said before, and so he's a late bloomer in terms of playing the game, and so his feel isn't quite there like most of these guys that have been playing their entire lives at a high level. Not only that, he's played center his whole time in college, and we're asking him to play on the perimeter, so he's making a huge adjustment while coming to the NBA. But I mean, that weak side block, that was impressive. Having said that, he was late coming over to trap the box or to protect the rim, but because of his length and his athleticism, he's able to make up for it and make a play like that. Now imagine when he gets in tune and he has a feel. If he's able to do some things like that defensively, he was even matched up with the point guard sometimes, the two guards sometimes, and he didn't do a great job. But for a guy, again, that played center his whole life, and now we're asking him to chase twos and guard ones and stuff like that, he did a decent job. And so getting some time under his belt could be beneficial, not just to him, but to us too in the long run. And so, I'm excited about him. He had one rebound, and I let him know it. He's got to have more than one rebound. Now, in his defense, there weren't a lot of rebounds to get because they shot 75% or 63% or 74% from the field. So not a lot of misses, but he's got to find ways to continue to rebound while playing defense. And then, you know, you guys saw some of his offensive skill set. I mean, he's got great hands, and he tries to make the simple play, and he's got good footwork, and he's long, and he can finish around the rim. And So if they put a smaller guy on him, he's going to go through their chest and get fouled or score the bucket.